Well, build my gallows and build them high. Makes a long time climbing before I die. I want the chance to spit in his eyes. Well, he gave me balls, but I can see between to a dusty yard and a long gone green. They call that freedom, if you know what I mean. And I drown my sorrows, but the whiskey's gone.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Shortbangers. This is episode 108, 108 in old money. Joined today by Colin. Colin, how you doing?
I'm good, mate. Aye, good. I've been in the office today, so absolutely knackered. Getting that bus in the morning and a bus home. All the pre-lockdown trials and tribulations.
All the stuff that we took for granted before, eh, that's now like a pain in the arse.
Yeah. It's a try estimate. Is it? Will I wait on the express? Will I wait on the express bus, or will I just jump on the normal one? All that kind of things. Looking at my wee tracker this morning, going, right, it's 11 minutes till the express bus, which is a wee bit down the road, or it's 7 minutes till the normal one. Right, the last time I went in, the normal one was away well earlier, or for longer, before the express came, so I'll just wait. Nah, I'll just go get the normal again, fuck it. Go to the bottom of the road, half a mile down the road, and behind the express. I'm like, you're fucking joking. Like, that's meant to be 4 minutes, at least 4 minutes behind us. And then it doesn't stop for fucking Gilmer and all the way up to the wine glass. It's not called that anymore, but you came what I mean.
Aye.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Bastard.
Right. We'll put 25 minutes on the clock. We'll get started with some questions. So we're catching up on questions as well, because we sort of fell behind, which isn't normal for us. So if you hadn't heard your questions yet and you've no check to see if it's on the subscriber issues, because some of the questions landed in there rather than the normal one, then we might get to your question today. So first one tonight comes from Ian T. He says, did Fran Healy really not appreciate that it always rained on him because he lived in Glasgow?
Aye. I wonder if he wrote that song when he was young and he hadn't really been outside Glasgow before. So it's true that I used to hate it when I used to play rugby. You go through to Glasgow, it'd be a nice day here, you get through to Glasgow and it was fucking wet. Always. We've been quite fortunate in recent times with going to football, like the semi-finals at Easter are usually all right. Rain, man. Always seems to rain through there.
That's stupid thinking it was today, but what you'd say to somebody to win. Like, why is it fucking raining? Probably because I lied to somebody. But you think somebody could have just ruled that out early doors for him and says, fuck it, it's much more complex than that, Fran. To be fair.
See, it's raining on karma.
Everybody, unless everybody's lying.
Well, everybody does lie, don't they?
Well, there is that.
There's nobody that's never told a lie.
No, well, if you've ever told your bairn that there's Santa.
Yeah, well, that's true. Right.
Okay. That's as much as you need to do, eh? How come that's an alright lie? Like, the mind's up with it, it's just accepted.
Can I have to actually tell my daughter this year? Or go fucking made the mistake to get my oldest to tell her. Because she's 11, she's in primary 7. And we got all the way through, and she still was, like, fucking adamant. Like, somebody's got to have to tell her. She's in high school soon, eh? And my oldest like that. She fucking knows. Like, I'll speak to her. I'm saying, you get Santa's nose true, eh? She's like, what? I'm getting tears in that. I'm like, oh, for fuck's sake, why do I say that, cunt?
I've been getting grief for telling the girls because they were pissing me off. It was like there was no Easter Bunny. Like, the Easter Bunny has never been that. I'm the same, never been like Santa, eh? But apparently that broke the magic. It's not like Santa. That was my argument. As I was annoyed, it's not fucking Santa.
We never
really
that.
Christmas, like.
No, just get some fucking chocolate. We never ever done that. One in this is like never done the Easter Bunny. Fuck's sake! Well, like, I think my folk make a big fuss about that. Just like
same here.
But then we're not religious. I don't know if it's a religious thing that folk do it as well. I don't know.
Hope they created bunnies.
I don't know.
Right, anyway, but what we're saying, Fran probably did realise eventually it was because he was from Glasgow. Fancy
yes,
your question, Ian.
And I think he believes in karma. I think I said that, but you were talking because of the. Is it because I lied? No, that's all right. We're allowed to talk. But the was it because I lied when I was 17? And he's thinking that's because that's why it's raining. So he's thinking it's karma.
Very specific age as well. Like, that makes him bear. The fact that he thought it might be because he was lying, that's maybe already pretty stupid. Once. Well, maybe.
Yeah, he maybe only ever lied once when he was 17, or it just rhymed better.
Aye, probably just for songwriting purposes.
Yeah.
Right. Whiskey Craig said, if the team, as in us, had to house a ghost with no control over its actions, who would they like to be haunted by and why?
It's not really something I've ever considered before. Who and why? Well, I wouldn't want anything scary. Just for the hassle. Like, you know, they're a ghost, they're not going to be able to do anything, because they can't, like, strangle you. Because they're. But what about, like, John Lennon? Nice and calm and peaceful, and you just sort of sing in the corner and that.
Aye. I think he'd be criticising the other music that you put on, though. Like, he could be judgmental, because I always got the impression with John Lennon, yeah, he's quite a judgmental character, and I think that would, he'd probably just get on your tits after a while.
He's like one of the guys that read the Q magazine and just sort of repeat it back to you. Do you still get Q magazine?
I don't know.
NME and Melody Maker, wasn't it? There was another one. There's a few of them, you could get. Kind of
Kerrang. There was Uncle Kerrang, if you like all the rock music.
Yeah,
I never bought that, but
yeah, I bought Q in that a few times. Like, I don't think I every week.
No,
but it was, or every month. Sorry, but I can't remember the last time I saw that in the shop. I don't really go looking at magazines in the shop anymore, though. It used to be a thing. Yeah, I used to buy papers and magazines. I used to work in a paper and magazine place. Not a petrol station that sold them. but what's the question? Oh, hey, John Lennon.
I will go. Who was the boy that played Columbo? Peter Falk. Is that his name?
Aye. Yes.
I'd go with him probably, because Ken, when something's happened and you didn't care what's happened and you try to get to the bottom of it, having a detective kicking about the place, who could kick about. Probably witness it happening.
Gin. Just one more thing.
That's who I want to be haunted by. Just because I think that's practical.
Or just, is Angela Lansbury in Egypt?
I don't know.
She's a good investigator. Murder, she wrote wifey.
She's bound to be dead now.
Aye, must be, yeah. I've got to Google that.
Can you Google that? While you're Googling that, I'll ask the next question, which was also for Whiskey Craig, who says, what's the ultimate toasty?
Oh. It's not the thing I have a lot of, actually. Still alive, she's 96.
What?
Can I? Well, maybe when she dies, she can become my ghost.
Aye. Right to her and ask her.
Can't even lie. Just to read it. It's another theme tune for the theme tune question for the last week, 2 weeks ago, whenever it was. Oh, a toasty. Right, it's got to have cheese in it.
Cheese is a prerequisite for a toasty.
Can't have a toasty with cheese. What kind of cheese? Does it depend what else you're having on it?
I'll go with bacon and brie's my favourite toasty. If I was in a shop that did them, that's what I would have. Bacon and brie. A little bit of cranberry in it.
Mm. See, that's the thing though, right? I was just going to ask that. See, when you have a toasty, like I might do that at Christmas, that bacon and brie. Because I always have too much brie at Christmas. When do you put the cranberry in? Do you put it before you toast it? I'm thinking one of the absolutely Breville machines.
Yeah. You pretty much make it as you're going to eat it. Yeah, so it would be hot, but it would be fucking really hot as well when it comes out. Scalding.
Always wearing that. It's like, see if you were to put like mayonnaise in one and then toast it. I never do that. Like, cause I always think, oh, you're cooking the mayonnaise then.
My daughter likes to have mayonnaise on the outside. You know, you butter the outside of the bread when you're putting it in. Make a toasty. Sometimes use mayonnaise for that. She likes the flavour. It gives it.
Well, now it's steady butter.
Aye.
Does that work? Steady
butter. Yeah.
Hmm. I wouldn't fancy that. It'd be too sickly. Too much. Too much mayonnaise, would it not?
Ah, it's no loads of it. Like, it's no dollops. It's just like a thin scraping. Anyway, it's worth a try. Well, what are you having in as your filling?
I don't know. I quite like a... probably go with mozzarella, I think, because it melts quite well in the in heat. Yeah. Bacon, like probably like a fry up sort of thing. Bacon and sausage. Bacon, sausage, mozzarella. What else would you put on there? Would I go bacon? Would I go black pudding and haggis? Maybe not. I know with the cheese. That would go very
well. They're not going to fit in your Breville. If you stack it too high, you're causing yourself problems. That's no ceiling.
Yeah. Yeah. We've got one of the deeper fill ones.
What have you?
It's not that much different, but it does make a difference. If that makes sense, you know, it's not like it's a fucking big.
We were talking about bread on the Shortbangers that got deleted last week.
Aye.
I can't mind if we talked about it in the one that
did
we
recreate it.
Did we recreate it?
But I can't Breville, remember.
If you've got Warburton's bread, Breville shite for a toastie because the square's tiny compared to the big bread.
So what do you do in that scenario there?
Trim the bread.
We just make one at a time because there's two spaces. Well, make one and just put it in the middle.
Does that work?
Aye. It does. Yep.
Right, I'll try that next time.
Stick it in the middle. It gives you a different thing though. It doesn't give you the line right down the like the diagonal line across it. Because you get extra wee lines, but you can just cut it yourself, eh?
Yeah.
It still works, though.
Is there any design flaw, really? Like, why did it make them? Because even if it's no more buttons, it doesn't fit a bit of bread.
Oh, it's small bits of bread, like. It'd be the small war buttons. What did they speak about again? This was the colours, eh? Because this is green, and John was doubting there was a green war button.
Green was the extra thick one.
Aye.
Right. Fattest prickers, have peacocks got too many feathers?
Too many for who? Like
for them? For peacocking about? Aye.
For peacocking about?
We're going to eat their peacock business.
Aye. Maybe just... Well, who's to say, like...
Us. That's when we got asked. This is like... We get the final say on it.
Well, like, then.
You're happy
with it.
You're happy with it. The fine is there, leave them be.
Yep.
There was a story one of my mates tells me. So down at the in Dunfermline, there's a big park called Pittencrieff Park or the Glen, as it's called locally, and there's peacocks kick about there. And there is a sort of urban legend about one of the peacocks ending up in people's curries, as one of the local curry houses were short of birds to cook, and they used a peacock apparently. Sounds like a lot of shite to me. That's the story.
I think they would have just stuck the dogs and cats and that, like everybody else.
They're not commonplace down at the Glen, eh? But peacocks are kind of bennied in there. And squirrels. There's not enough meat in a squirrel, wouldn't you think? Jockey 1875, why does a grapefruit taste and look nothing like a grape?
I don't know, is it because it's not a grape?
Oh, well, it is because it's not a grape, but get a better name then. It's like they couldn't name it more like a grape because a grape has a fruit in it. So,
yeah, I'm just looking it up. But
why is it
do you like grapefruit? Yeah, why is it called that?
Grapefruit, take or leave, is nice if you add a load of sugar on it. Like, see if you were having it for your breakfast. It kind of does away with the health benefits, isn't it? If you just load it with sugar, that's the only way you can eat it.
Yeah, it says here. Grapes belong to the, I don't know how to pronounce these words, but grapefruits are a hybrid between pomelo and sweet oranges. They belong to the citrus. I assume it's genre, but it's genus, G-E-N-U-S, whatever that means.
Genus.
So I don't know if it is. I don't know if it even is a grape. I don't know if it's just that. It's throwing you down the wrong path.
If it's a citrus fruit, which we can all agree that it is based on that information, calling it a grapefruit is even more absurd. So
maybe that was called it first, though, and the grape's been called after the grapefruit.
Well, maybe. Or maybe it was discovered by Mr. Grapefruit, and they've just named it after him. And it was just a happy coincidence that there was already a fruit called grapes.
Yeah.
Sir John Grapefruit. The monsieur asks, which do you prefer, if any, stoves made with potted meat or beef sausages? Potted meat, I take it, I mean corned beef.
It must be, aye. That's not really stoves, that's corned beef. They don't call that corned beef hash.
Corned beef hash. English, I think you can make stoves with corned beef or with sausages. Not stoves for fucking ages.
Neither have I. Because they would moan about it, the girls would moan about it if I made that. It's dead easy to make as well, aye. My mum always says you make it with roast beef, like the leftover roast beef for Sunday roast. You get your tatties left over and you get your beef. You just lob it in with some onions. You do like onions though. How do you go about eating the stovies?
Well, I've explained this before. I've not picked onions out. If there was onions in it, I'd just eat it. But if it was like big chunky bits of onion, I would probably move them to the side, because that.
So you wouldn't make it without it.
But I made a curry last night and I chopped up a whole onion and chucked it in. Quite happy. I was like, that'll be. I'll know. I appreciate what they bring to a dish when it's one of the ingredients, but it's no go-to for me to eat.
Aye, got you. Okay. So my mum would all say roast beef, but sausages I like sausages in it or beef rather than corned beef. I don't mind corned beef in it, but I'd rather definitely prefer others.
I quite liked it with corned beef. When lockdown happened, the Stevens, the bakers in Fife, they put on a delivery service. So we used to get a kind of weekly delivery for them. With like your brides and that, but they did they sold stovies, but it came in like a big carrier bag, which always kind of put me off. It was like, this doesn't look the nicest when it comes in a polythene bag.
Was it coming frozen or was it?
Nah, just chilled. It was tasty, it was nice, but it doesn't look the nicest thing, does it? Like stovies, it looks.
No. It looks like it's basically, it's just tatties and that was smashed up by some bigger bits in it, and some meat. We got our Christmas order for the butchers. We got, you obviously got the turkey and that, but then you look at you got all the extra shite at Christmas? I'm like, aye. Oh, God, a couple of bits of stovies and we'll have them one night in between. Okay, when we're kind of be arse cooking and that, just take it out of the freezer or the fridge. And it came in like a wee, I think it was in a wee plastic tub, and or two wee plastic tubs, and just whacked it on a pot to heat it up. And the girls were like, we're not eating that, so we hadn't ordered it for them, so like, that's fine, we'll have the stovies in. And you were getting stovies for a proper butcher's and that. They got a pizza, we ordered them a pizza, and we're sitting eating these stovies, they're going, wish I did the pizza. It was really relented,
because
the butcher's a brilliant butcher's as well, eh? It's like excellent, everything you get if it's excellent. They were just like a wee bit disappointed, eh?
Aye.
It was a proper beef, proper roast beef and all that ones, I think they were, eh? Just
probably,
like, I think it might have been Hug Money we were sitting eating that. We're like, get that for Hug Money, we'll have that.
There's probably a tipping point if the ingredients are too good. It detracts from it, because stoves isn't meant to be like all the good stuff that goes
just
in it, is it?
Do
you know what I mean? That's it, so it probably does kind of tip it over. Hi Bees, Alan says, did you two find what they were looking for? No, the last I heard. I'm honest with you, the song came on in one of my playlists earlier and still hadn't found what they were looking for.
Still looking. It's world peace in that they were looking for, though, wasn't it?
Was it? Well, I'm not sure.
I don't know. It was an end. I don't know if it was.
Do you think they could have helped themselves by no searching where the streets had no name?
That must have made it a bit difficult, eh?
That's it. Must have. Fucking worst map writers ever.
Yeah, before you got another question, you know, just something came to my head there. I don't know what triggered you two and all that to this, but do you know how Neighbours is finishing? We've spoke about Neighbours and that before.
Yeah,
you know, it's finishing soon. I don't know, summertime maybe. Kylie and Jason are going back into it. Did you know that?
Jane told me that fact, because we were trying to figure out whether they got paid loads to go back on it. Because they're bound to have, like, or do you think they did it like sentimentally? They just fucking just took a nominal fee.
I read an article about it, and Donovan was saying it's employed my family for years. Like, it made him famous.
Yeah.
But his dad was in it, and his daughter is currently in it.
All right, I didn't get that.
Aye, his dad was, would have been when we were younger, like, his dad was somebody else's dad in it. Fucking family was it. Oh, do you remember Willis, maybe? The Willis family, remember them?
Cody,
couldn't pronounce that word right. Really cool.
Yeah.
I think that was, he was the dad, Doug. Doug, I don't know how interesting this is for anybody. Like, it's not even a question.
Well, I'm sure everybody's
but we might get to the bottom if it's Ramsey Street or what Sherlin's name was. Was that the question we asked?
That was, because was Madge a ghost in that question? Was she because Irish Madge. the ghost of Irish Madge.
Oh, she's dead in the programme.
Aye, but the actress is dead. No. Irish or dead. Harold. right, this is an actual question for you to figure out. Right? This is like a riddle or puzzle or whatever. Write it down and see if you can follow it. Ready?
Okay.
Right, Tim was born on a Friday, 20th of March, 1959.
Right.
Okay. Tim was born on a Friday, 20 March 1959. John was born on Wednesday, 22nd of May 1996. My birthday coming up for him.
Yep.
Colin was born on Saturday, 1st of May 1999. Happy birthday, Colin.
Thank you.
Can you explain how it is that all three celebrate birthdays on the same day of the week every year, e.g. this year on a Sunday?
Sorry, I was coughing there. Same day of the week every year.
So this year their birthday would have been on Sunday, but all their birthdays, despite being born on different days of the week, all their birthdays fall on the same day each year.
I wish I'd never wasted the fucking ink writing that down.
It's just the correct answer here. No, we can't explain it.
That's right. <yes. laughs> Did he send the fucking answer in?
No answer. TG Wallace, you can send an answer. Is it to do with, the different months having different... Oh, I suppose they're both two that are in May. So it's like the different months having different number of days, and then obviously like your leap years come into play, maybe.
Exactly.
But if two of them are in...
The first of May to the 22nd of May, that's 3 weeks apart. Right? There's 21 days between them.
Ah, but the years will be relevant as well, because Tim was 1959.
And there'll be leap years and all that.
Aye.
Fuck it up.
So...
How was it Tim, John and Colin and not Matthew, John and Colin?
I don't know.
Did you change your names?
I think it was potentially because of the character limit on a tweet. Because it is quite a long tweet. So... Right. I'm not changing my name to Tim for the sake of a question that I didn't get an answer to.
We do have to answer that. We do have to reply to that asking for the answer, because that's... we've not got anything to give away prize-wise, if anybody could work that out.
No, so if folk can text in the answer if you know it. And TG Willis, you can message us the answer.
DM it.
DM
it. So that we're not giving that away to everybody.
So it's no giveaway. What we'll do, Colin, is we'll pretend that secretly we do know the answer to that one. To DM it, and we just don't spoil the fun for anybody else.
When you write it down like that, that's pretty obvious.
Aye.
You can see it. So aye, if you could just confirm that I'm right in the DMs.
Colin will show his barking once he's seen that text for you.
What? There was a year, is it Olympic definitely. Year that's leap year?
Oh, right.
Is it Olympic year that's the leap year? It ties in, doesn't it?
Oh, is it again?
I've never paid
attention to that at all.
And then, I might make that up. But I thought it was. But there was a year they missed the leap year out. They didn't have one.
They missed the leap year out.
We're
not having a leap year this year.
Aye. Or that 4 years. It's the 2000, 2004, 2008, 2012. Aye, so it is Olympics. It's the Olympic year. I'm sure they missed one out 1 year. One circuit.
One leap year they just off. Then they needed this year. So
Yeah. I'm sure there was. If somebody could text that in as well, that'd be good.
I can't remember that happening. It's a totally arbitrary thing as well, wouldn't it? Like all the months and years as well. Somebody can who was it? There's Robert Inshaw. His tweets, they got sent to us. With the sort of questions that he had, and he was like, who said it was this time or this date?
Yeah. I've just Googled it.
Right.
And I'm talking shite, but I'm not, right? So I'm thinking I remember a year not being a leap year when it should have been. And apparently I've never known that in my lifetime. But the next time a leap year will be skipped is 2100. So we'll not be here.
So they will do it.
They do, aye. Yeah.
Imagine they forget. Wonder what would happen.
I know. Every 400 years, we're off by a whole day. So every 400 years, they skip the leap year. Apparently.
Well, there you go. All right.
So I must have known that and actually applied it and thought we never had a leap year that year. But
aye. You were just like, sure. Like 300 years ago. Yeah. You've done, I do that sometimes, yes. Just think back to 300 years ago and whether or not we had a leap year.
Well, I've got that much knowledge up here. I just don't know what to do with it. See birthdays for leap years.
Well, if you were February 29th when you were born.
Aye, you were born that day, right? And obviously, you're not going to say you're 4 year old in that when you're fucking 16 and stuff. But folk claim it as the 28th of February, don't they?
I don't know. Do you get to pick? Can you have it on the 28th or can you have it on the 1st of March?
Well, it should be the 1st of
March. Aye, 1st of March.
It shouldn't be a choice because 28th of February, you weren't born. You were born the day after the 20th of February.
Yeah.
So, no, you can't claim the 20th of February is the rules.
Like, unlucky.
The folk do. They just would grab it a day early. Like, no, you can wait till your fucking birthday on the 1st of March. Or the day after the 20th of February, we'll call it.
Day after the 28th, that's your birthday. Hybees Island said, who had the best one-hit wonder?
Well, you're the mayor guy with the music and that than me. My immediate thing, and that's not a good one, is the biggest one I can remember was Chesney Hawks. Remember that? That was like, but I didn't particularly like it. But it was at number one for ages, wasn't it?
Aye.
Oh yeah, I also can't remember having a second song. It was Return of the Mac. Mark Morrison.
Yeah.
I can't remember him ever having a second song. I just saw him on Top of the Pops 96, I think, the other week. I sent you a wee video of mine. With that boy dancing in the background.
He looked like the sort who would be right into that sort of music as well.
Aye, did I? I can't remember having a second song. So that was quite a big, that was like big in America and everything, that song. You got any?
Aye. I wonder, it's hard to tie it down to our best one, isn't it? I was trying to think of, like, if we could have a funny answer to that one and sort of take it as somebody getting sparked out, you know.
Aye.
But I couldn't think of anything funny there either.
It's not so good.
No food over my head. I try to think, like, we've had decent... Because most of the one-hit wonders are one-hit wonders for a reason. It's like they're maybe like it's a novelty record, which tend to be shite, or
Mr. Blobby, mind that one.
Aye, Mr. Blobby, or Christmas number ones and things like that. And you would try to think of like indie bands from back in the day that had good songs out, but
mind them. It wasn't quite indie, but it was about that time. Spaceman, mind that.
That was a shite song, though, for the Levi's advert. Was he called Jazz Man? The boy who sang, I'm sure it was called Jazz Man. Not like Jazz Man, a superhero that's into fucking jazz. What a shit superhero that would be. Yeah. But because Levi's put it in the advert, it was massive. He had a big one-hit wonder with that one. But he was in the papers getting at the big fucking Oasis style. I'm going the best of this and I'm the best of that. Fucking dreadful. But that actual song, apart from the wee hook that they used for the advert, which was dead catchy, like if you listen to that wee bit, you go, oh, that's got a cool song. The rest of the song was bullshit. Like, fucking awful. So, I don't care if he would count as the best.
Quite big, that was straight in at number
one. It
was
one, big, aye. It was like a big hit.
That was on that Top of the Pops as well. Top of the 96 or 97, it was out.
Aye.
That's a really good series, that, for us at our age. Top of the Pops in the 90s. You watch it and you go, fuck me, how much better was the music in the 90s?
Oh, it was miles better. I think it was... Grievous
and the Heart. D-Light, was it? Grievous and the Heart. Did they have any other songs out?
Pass.
Because that was a good tune.
Pass, aye.
Can't remember any other songs.
That was good. They had
a handful of songs.
Did they?
No, they had. Yeah,
Well, only anybody remembers was only one must have been a hit though. Yeah. Or did they?
I think they had a few, like, remember the other one? I'm thinking the one was, it wasn't good either, right enough, but Shampoo, remember them? Trouble. Uh-oh, We're in Trouble.
Aye.
We see them at the Radio 1 Roadshow.
Wakefield, the Saturday night.
She had another song though. She had another one after that. She definitely had another song or two after that. Gina G, there's another one.
Aye.
Eurovision one. Some shit songs, eh? The best one out of them is Groove Is in the Heart, and I can't remember them having a second song. But they might have. They probably had all fucking albums, eh?
Aye. Right, anyway, we're out of time for this episode, mate. So, I flew by, 25 minutes, or it's been half an hour or something like that. I don't know. Who's counting? Timer went off as we were answering that question. Sort of, not lost count. If you like that, you want to hear some more, go and subscribe. Longbangers.hubwave.net. There's Shortbangers Extra. I was going to say Extra Time. It's not called Shortbangers Extra Time. That's Longbangers. Shortbangers Extra will be on there for subscribers. So we'll carry on and ask some more questions and answer them inanely. Is that the right way to say? As bad as we are at kind of answering them. Anyway, thanks for sending your questions. We'll see you next time.
Well, they trailed me down when I broke free. I drank all the whiskey in Tennessee.